let's go.
Come ti immagini alla fine di questa stagione?
È difficile dire subito adesso dove saremo, quindi ovviamente vuoi fare più progresso possibile rispetto alla stagione scorsa, quindi vedremo. Ovviamente vogliamo mantenere la competitività che abbiamo avuto l'anno scorso e anche migliorarla se è possibile.
Invece che cosa pensi di essere migliorato maggiormente l'anno scorso, nella scorsa stagione?
Io penso in generale la vettura era molto più competitiva, anche il motore ha fatto un grande passo in avanti. Come squadra operativamente abbiamo lavorato bene, abbiamo colto le occasioni con la strategia eccetera, quindi abbiamo sempre raccolto i punti quando abbiamo avuto la possibilità, solo in poche occasioni diciamo non siamo riusciti a prendere i punti che meritavamo. Quindi speriamo di rimanere questa competitività anche durante questo anno.
Ecco, hai parlato dei motori, che cosa vi aspettate da questi nuovi motori Honda?
Ovviamente ci aspettiamo ancora più progresso, perché l'anno scorso è stato un passo in avanti molto notevole e speriamo che si faccia un altro passo in avanti così.
Invece parlaci un attimo di questa nuova macchina, nuova livrea, nuovi colori, nuovo nome addirittura.
Sì, è tutto nuovo, abbastanza diverso da quel punto di vista. La livrea sarà diversa, il nome è cambiato, però dal punto di vista tecnico è tutto molto simile.
How do you feel respect of the last season, considering all what it happened in 2019?
Yeah, I feel good, of course. This year, compared to last year at the same time, I have double more experience. Last year at the same time I had only 1 year in Formula One. Now I have 2 seasons, so I'm still really new. It's not a lot of experience, but I feel more prepared with the team, in what I want from the team, what I want from the car. I feel more prepared physically and mentally as well. So no, ready and excited to start the season.
Which is the most important lesson you learned from the last season?
Well, I think, you know, the team doesn't, even with changing name, we don't really change the old people, engineer and the whole team, from Toro Rosso to AlphaTauri. And it's the first time for me in my career in single seater that I'm going to do a second year with the same team. I've been always changing every season, so I think it's a good base to work from and to start. We ended with a podium last year in Brazil and everybody is super motivated to do well.
If there is something you want to demonstrate more than all this year?
I think on a personal level I want to show my speed. I want to show my consistency and always try to improve myself as a driver. Try to do even better than I did last year. We had a really good end of the season, but this year we'll have to do even better and be even more consistent.
Which is your objective for this season?
Well, it's early to say, because the car at the moment, we know what we have improved, but we don't know what the others have changed. So very difficult to give any result target. Of course, we want to do well. Of course, we want to score many points. But objectively, yeah, it's too early.
How do you see this new season coming?
I think potentially it's going to be a great season, because we have regulation stability, which means they will be finessing their packages but not making big revolution changes. So I think they will all be competitive at the start of the year. Of course, I don't know who's going to be the champion, but the favourite, you have to say Hamilton is starting like that. But yeah, I think that if you look at Max's performances and Charles at Ferrari, you've got some big competition.
What about this new car, these new colours, this new name, new livrea, everything?
Yeah, Toro Rosso becomes AlphaTauri. So, you know, the journey for Toro Rosso began in 2006. They had this incredible victory in 2008 in Monza with Vettel driving the car. And since then, they've served their purpose as a development team for the Young Driver program for Red Bull. This is all part of a strategy for a global rollout of the AlphaTauri brand. And I think that as a fashion line, they'll want success. So I think the expectation on the team and the pressure on the team will be more this year.
And how do you see the difference between the races in your age and in this new electronic age?
Yeah, I think that the competition is always there. And I think that irrespective of whether it was the 50s or whether it's now, you know, the drivers have to perform, but of course the technology at their disposal is quite different. The hybrid Formula One cars have a lot of technology, they generate a lot of horsepower, but equally they're heavier, you know, 730 something kilos. When I raced they were 605 kilos, so they've gained a lot of baggage as they've gained all this technology.
How do you see the level of the pilots?
Yeah, I think that there's very high standards across the board and a few exceptional drivers. So let's see everyone, how they deliver, how they perform and what this championship gives us.
Un saluto ai lettori di Fanpage. Let's go!